So hi everyone and welcome to the revision session of PIB 247 for the month of October 2022. Yes, you have heard it right, the revision session for the month of October 2022. Now from now onwards, for every month we are going to conduct this session, and of course ye jo session hai aapke liye kafi helpful hoga to quickly revise whatever you have studied in the past one month. All right, so let's begin with the session. And yeah, jo session ka speed hai wo thoda sa zyada hoga, the speed will be quite fast because we have already discussed all these news and all these questions in the past month, in the month of October. So main jaldi se question padhunga, I will tell you the explanation, and in the meantime you have to tell me the answer. And total 89 questions are there. ऑलमोस्ट सारे ही क्वेश्चन मैंने उठा लिए हैं, सो दैट कुछ भी ना छूटे. आई जस्ट डोंट वॉन्ट कि आपका एक क्वेश्चन भी एग्जाम में छूटे. ऑलराइट, सो लेट्स बिगिन विद द सेशन. एंड इफ यू वांट टू हैव द पीडीएफ ऑफ दिस सेशन गाइस, इफ यू वांट टू हैव द पीडीएफ ऑफ दिस सेशन विद मार्क्ड आंसर्स, देन यू कैन ज्वाइन द टेलीग्राम चैनल. द लिंक इज प्रोवाइडेड इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन. ऑलराइट, एंड आरबीआई ग्रेड बी 2023 द ऑनलाइन क्लासेस हैव बीन स्टार्टेड, सो इफ यू वांट टू एस द एग्जामिनेशन इन द अपकमिंग ईयर, देन यू कैन एनरोल इन द कोर्स. ओके, so let's begin with the very first question, which says consider the following statements with respect to telecom technology development fund scheme, and you have to identify the correct statement. Now first of all, this scheme has been launched very recently in the year 2022, in the month of October 2022 isko launch kiya gaya hai by the Ministry of Communication. Right, Ministry of Communication is the nodal ministry to implement it, and the objective of this scheme, Telecom Technology Development. What is the name of the scheme? Telecom Technology Development, which means the Ministry of Communication is intended to develop the telecom technology under the scheme in the rural and remote areas of the country. Right? जो हमारे rural और remote areas हैं country के, वहां पे telecom technology को develop किया जाएगा under this scheme, and thereby reducing, or you can say thereby bridging, the digital divide between the rural and urban area. जो digital divide है अभी भी rural और urban India में, उसको कम किया जाएगा with this scheme. Remember, this scheme will be funded by Universal Service Obligation Fund. Right? Universal Service Obligation Fund के अंदर होगा, and whatever be the total annual fund under USOF, 5% of the annual outlay will be given to this scheme. 5% of USOF will be allotted to this scheme, or उससे ज्यादा भी हो सकता है, उससे कम भी हो सकता है. इट विल बी डिसाइडेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट. ऑलराइट, एंड या टेलीकॉम सेंटर ऑफ एक्सीलेंस इंडिया एंड सेंटर फॉर डेवलपमेंट ऑफ टेलीमेटिक्स आर द इंप्लीमेंटिंग एजेंसी फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर स्कीम. एंड एनी प्रोजेक्ट, जो भी प्रोजेक्ट इसके अंदर इंप्लीमेंट होगा, द टाइमलाइन शैल बी 2 ईयर्स. विद इन 2 ईयर्स द प्रोजेक्ट हैज टू बी कंप्लीटेड. ऑलराइट, सो दैट इज ऑल. लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द स्टेटमेंट देन. इट हैज बीन लॉन्च टू क्रिएट 5G इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर इन अर्बन एरियाज. नो, it is incorrect. Telecom Center of Excellence India and Center for Development of Telematics are the implementing agencies. This is absolutely correct. And timeline for completion of a project under the scheme shall be 2 years. This is correct. ठीक है, अभी अभी हमने discuss किया. So 1, 2, and 3 are correct statement, which means option B will be the correct answer. All right. I hope this question is clear. Consider the following statements with respect to Swachh Sarvekshan 2022, and you have to identify the incorrect statement now. Please focus on the word whether they are asking correct statement or the incorrect statement. Okay, best cantonment was Ahmedabad cantonment. No, it was Deolali. Right, cleanest state with less than 100 ULBs, urban local bodies, is not Assam, it is Tripura. And what about a state having more than 100 ULB? It is Madhya Pradesh, which is the cleanest state. 6 cities have been awarded with 5-star garbage free cities. This is correct, and only 1 state has got the 7-star garbage free city rating. 7-star केवल एक ही state को city को मिला है, and that is Indore. ठीक है, fast mover city is Shivamoga, which is in Karnataka. This is correct. So 3 and 4 are correct, but we have to identify the incorrect statement, which means option D. Only 1 and 2 will be the correct answer. And in this survection, as per the result, best Ganga town की अगर हम बात करें, cleanest city again once again is Indore. तो I don't think वो आपको बताने की जरूरत होनी चाहिए. Best Ganga town with more than 1 lakh population, it is Haridwar in Uttarakhand. Haridwar in Uttarakhand. While best Ganga town with less than 1 lakh population, it is Bijnor. And where is this Bijnor? Uttar Pradesh. ठीक है, so option D is the correct answer. कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू स्वच्छ सर्वेक्षण ग्रामीण एंड यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट अगेन. Telangana has been ranked number one in the last states category. This is absolutely correct. There is no problem with it. Among small states and UTs, Delhi is at number one. Is that so? Remember, yaad karo, it is Andaman and Nicobar Island which is at number one. Top performing district is Nizamabad in Telangana. Not Nizamabad, it was Bhiwani from Haryana which was at number one. Nizamabad was at number three. And Madhya Pradesh has the maximum citizen feedback. No. Not Madhya Pradesh, it's Uttar Pradesh which has the maximum citizen feedback. Alright. And best, first Har Ghar Jal certified district, ki agar hum baat kare, to it was Burhanpur, which is in Madhya Pradesh. Right. So 2, 3 and 4 are incorrect, which means option B will be the correct answer. Question number 4. Consider the following statements with respect to PMUR 2.0 and you have to identify the correct statement. The second edition has been launched now. The first edition was launched last year and this scheme is for supporting young and budding authors. ठीक है, उनको mentorship provide कराने के लिए, to provide mentorship to the young and budding authors, the scheme was launched last year in the year 2021 and now the second edition has been launched. Under this scheme, mentorship is provided along with 50,000 rupee as stipend is provided for writing a book and then that written book, ठीक है, is published by, will be published by National Book Trust. National Book Trust. And this time in the second edition, 75 authors have been selected. Alright. So, first edition was in 2021. Any young author who is below 30 years of age is eligible. That is the age eligibility. Do remember it. And total 75 authors will be selected in the second edition. This is also correct. So, all are correct. Option D, all 1, 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. The second United Nations World Geospatial Information Congress is being organized by the Department of Economic and Social Affairs of the United Nations and hosted by the Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. In which city the Congress will take place? So the organizer is the Department of Economic and Social Affairs of United Nations, but there is a convener as well. And which organization is the convener? It is United Nations Committee of Experts on Global Geospatial Information Management. Right? This organization was the convener of this Congress. Right? And it took place in Hyderabad, which is in Telangana. Option C is the correct answer. Question number 6. Name the radio series launched by Election Commission of India in collaboration with All India Radio for voter awareness. Who is the Chief Election Commissioner of India? Write down in the comments. Kuch questions bhi main aapse puchunga, to please unke answer zarur karna. Aise hi khali mat baithe rehna. Okay? So who is the Chief Election Commissioner of India? Write down in the comments. And this radio series was named as Matdata Junction. Matdata in English means voter. Alright, option B is the correct answer. National Mission for Clean Ganga has approved 4 biodiversity parks in 4 districts of UP at a cost of rupees 2.97 crores. Which of the following is not among the 4 districts? Very interesting question. Generally, itna deep question ye log nahi poochte hain, but these days humne dekha hai ki examiner, I don't know ki kya kha ke wo paper bana rahe hain, so they are asking anything. So we have to prepare for anything. Okay. So Hapur, Bulandshahr, Budaon and Mirzapur are the 4 districts where this park will be made. So Prayagraj is not among the 4 districts. Option E is the correct answer. For which district of Jammu and Kashmir a milk product Kalari has been earmarked under one district one product program? So Kalari, remember, has been marked as a one district one product for Udhampur district. Udhampur district. Now can you tell me Udhampur is the Lok Sabha constituency of which cabinet minister? Yes, it is Dr. Jitendra Singh, the Minister of Science and Technology and the Minister of Earth Sciences. Option E is the correct answer. Which ministry has organized the capacity building workshop on price monitoring in New Delhi? Kaun si ministry ne capacity building workshop price monitoring wala jo tha wo New Delhi mein conduct kiya? So it was conducted by Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal. And he is the leader of Rajya Sabha as well. Name the portal launched by the Ministry of Defense for automation of sanction and disbursement of defense pension. It is nothing new. It was launched, I believe, in the year 2020, if I am not wrong. We will check. So, this पेंशन पोर्टल इज नेम्ड एज व्हाट? स्पर्श. बट क्योंकि ये एक जगह पे जिक्र में था, दैट इज व्हाई वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट इट इन द मंथ ऑफ अक्टूबर, एंड दैट इज व्हाई दिस क्वेश्चन इज हियर. फुल फॉर्म इज सिस्टम फॉर पेंशन एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन रक्षा, सिस्टम फॉर पेंशन एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन रक्षा इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ स्पर्श. डू रिमेंबर द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ स्पर्श एज वेल. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स इज इनकरेक्ट अबाउट क्रॉप रेजिड्यू मैनेजमेंट स्कीम. नाउ दिस स्कीम इज इट बेसिकली एड्रेस द एयर पोल्यूशन. इट एड्रेस इज द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ एयर पोल्यूशन विच अराइजेस ड्यू टू स्टबल बर्निंग. अभी अगर आप दिल्ली में रहते हैं तो आपको पता होगा इस बात का मतलब मैं क्या कह रहा हूँ. स्टबल बर्निंग से बहुत सारा धुआं दिल्ली की तरफ, एनसीआर की तरफ, यूपी की तरफ आता है, जो कि पंजाब हरियाणा में स्टबल बर्निंग होती है उसकी वजह से. सो टू एड्रेस दिस इशू दिस स्कीम वॉज लॉन्च इन द ईयर 2018-19 बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड फार्मर्स वेलफेयर हेडेड बाय नरेंद्र सिंह तोमर, राइट. एंड दिस इज अ सेंट्रल सेक्टर स्कीम. डू रिमेंबर दिस एज वेल. इट इज अ सेंट्रल सेक्टर स्कीम एंड ऑफकोर्स दिस स्कीम इज फॉर दिल्ली, पंजाब, हरियाणा एंड उत्तर प्रदेश. दिल्ली, पंजाब, हरियाणा एंड उत्तर प्रदेश बिकॉज दिस इशू जनरली लाइज इन दीज एरियाज एंड यूपी. दिल्ली, पंजाब, हरियाणा, यूपी एंड स्पेशली जो सबसे ज्यादा इंपैक्ट होता है वो दिल्ली में होता है बिकॉज दिल्ली इज ऑलरेडी ओवर क्राउडेड विद अ लॉट ऑफ व्हीकुलर पोल्यूशन, और उसके ऊपर से जब ये ऐड हो जाता है तो इट मेक्स द सिचुएशन वर्स. ओके, एंड इसमें होता क्या है बेसिकली, मतलब ठीक है इट एड्रेसेस द एयर पोल्यूशन ड्यू टू स्टबल बर्निंग, बट हाउ, दैट इज द इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन. तो बेसिकली क्रॉप रेजिड्यू मैनेजमेंट के लिए मशीनरी प्रोवाइड कराई जाती है. गवर्नमेंट प्रोवाइड्स क्रॉप रेजिड्यू मैनेजमेंट मशीनरी, राइट. एंड द कॉस्ट ऑफ दिस कॉस्ट ऑफ मशीनरी 50% ऑफ द कॉस्ट हैज टू बी बोर्न बाय द फार्मर एंड 50% इज प्रोवाइडेड बाय द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट. एंड फॉर 80% ऑफ द कॉस्ट ऑफ कस्टम हायरिंग सेंटर there is a provision of custom hiring center as well. Now first of all, what is this custom hiring center? Agar kisi farmer ke paas paisa nahi hai, if a farmer cannot afford this machinery, then he can take the machinery on rent from these custom hiring centers. And these custom hiring centers are being established by FPOs, right, cooperative societies and SHGs. Theek hai, to कस्टम हायरिंग सेंटर बनाने में जो भी खर्चा होता है 80% पैसा उनको वापस दे दिया जाता है बाय द गवर्नमेंट. सो दे हैव टू बेयर ओनली 20% ऑफ द कॉस्ट. ऑलराइट, सो दैट इज ऑल अबाउट द स्कीम. इट इज नॉट अ सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम. यस, इट वाज लॉन्च्ड इन 2018-19 एंड इट टारगेट्स टू रिड्यूस एयर पोल्यूशन कॉस्ट ड्यू टू स्टबल बर्निंग इन द एरियाज ऑफ पंजाब, हरियाणा, यूपी, एनसीटी, दिल्ली, गुजरात. नो, गुजरात में नहीं है, माउंटेन बेल्ट्स ऑफ, ठीक है. सो थर्ड स्टेटमेंट इनकरेक्ट हो गई. सो द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट इज, इनकरेक्ट निकालना है हमें 1 and 3 ओनली, राइट. ऑप्शन डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर, 1 and 3. व्हाट इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ सिटीज व्हिच इज अ जॉइंट प्रोग्राम बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स हेडेड बाय हरदीप सिंह पुरी, द फ्रेंच डेवलपमेंट एजेंसी, द यूरोपियन यूनियन एंड द नेशनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ अर्बन अफेयर्स. रिमेंबर, सिटीज स्टैंड्स फॉर सिटीज इन्वेस्टमेंट टू इनोवेट, इंटीग्रेट एंड सस्टेन. Cities investment to innovate, integrate and sustain is the full form, and this basically is the program to promote and develop innovative urban, actually innovative and sustainable also. ठीक है, आज की डेट में सिर्फ इनोवेशन की जरूरत नहीं है, that innovation has to be sustainable as well. Innovative and sustainable urban infrastructure projects. This is all about this program. That is the basic objective, right? And this is the full form, option D. And these are the organizers. Okay. Which of the following program is not being executed by RPF? So there are various programs which are being executed or implemented or enforced by Railway Protection Force for ensuring the protection and safety of the railway passengers. So in me se kaun sa nahi hai? Operation Nanhe Farishte is there under this RPF. Rescues the लॉस्ट चिल्ड्रन, अगर कोई बच्चा खो गया है तो उसके लिए रेस्क्यूइंग ऑपरेशन है. व्हील चेयर इज नॉट द ऑपरेशन. जीवन रक्षा में दे चेक फॉर द एक्सीडेंट्स विच टुक प्लेस ड्यूरिंग द बोर्डिंग और डी बोर्डिंग ऑफ द ट्रेन. मातृशक्ति इज टू हेल्प द प्रेग्नेंट वुमेन पैसेंजर्स. जो प्रेग्नेंट वुमेन पैसेंजर्स है उनकी मदद करने के लिए है. एंड देन ऑपरेशन डिग्निटी इज फॉर रेस्क्यूइंग दी अगेन लॉस्ट पीपल, लॉस्ट पर्संस के रेस्क्यू के लिए. दिस इज फॉर द रेस्क्यूइंग ऑफ लॉस्ट चाइल्ड एंड दिस इज फॉर द रेस्क्यूइंग ऑफ लॉस्ट पर्सन एज अ होल, चाइल्ड हो या कोई एडल्ट हो. तो ऑपरेशन व्हील चेयर इज द करेक्ट आंसर, ऑप्शन बी. कंसिडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू एशिया पैसिफिक ब्रॉडकास्टिंग यूनियन एंड यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. सो रिमेंबर दिस एशिया पैसिफिक ब्रॉडकास्टिंग यूनियन, इट इज द वर्ल्ड्स बिगेस्ट ब्रॉडकास्टिंग यूनियन and it has 253 broadcasting organization under its ambit from 67 countries. From 67 countries, it was established in 1964 and it is headquartered in Kuala Lumpur. Kuala Lumpur of course is in Malaysia, right? So this is incorrect, this is incorrect, and incorrect nikalna hai, so 2 and 3 will be the correct answer, option C. All right. Power Foundation of India in association with which of the following organization is running a campaign to create awareness on Agni Tattva under life, which is lifestyle for environment. I hope you all know this. So with which of the following organization it is doing it? So it is Vibha, which in Vijnan Bharati, which in short is Vibha, right? And remember, it was conducted under under an umbrella campaign which is known as what? Sumangalam. Right, Sumangalam is an umbrella campaign. Under this umbrella campaign, this Agni Tattva campaign was organized. National Mission for Clean Ganga and Sahakar Bharati have organized Vishal Kisan Sammelan workshop as part of the targeted campaign under Namami Gange program and Earth Ganga to promote natural farming amongst the farmers in the Ganga basin. In which state the Sammelan was organized? Very easy, very straightforward and very direct question. It was organized in Haryana. Option E is the correct answer. A committee of experts on sustainable finance constituted by International Financial Services Authority has submitted its final report. Now, itna sab kuch padhne ki zarurat nahi hoti hai during the examination. Just read the first line, right? Ki about the passage is about which of the which thing, right? Ab jaise this passage is about this committee, right? And then try to skip the entire paragraph and come to the last line. So in the last line, the actual question is being asked generally. So who was the chairperson of this committee, right? Is tarike se hi hota hai. So apna time aap bacha sakte ho during the examination. So it was headed by Mr. C.K. Mishra. Option D is the correct answer. One second. Yeah. International Electrotechnical Commission is a not-for-profit organization developing international standards in the field of electrical and electronics. So where are the headquarters of IEC? Very simple question, but it can be asked in your examination because it was in news, right? It is headquartered in Geneva. Option A is the correct answer. All India Institute of Ayurveda has signed an MOU with National Institute of Advanced Industrial Science and Technology of which country to promote research collaboration and building capacities in the field of Indian Ayurvedic system of traditional medicines. So can you identify this country? It is Japan. Yes, you are absolutely right. It is Japan. Option E is the correct answer. Which organization has launched the India Mobile Congress 2022 along with Department of Telecommunication? ये हमने पहले भी discuss किया हुआ है कई बार. और ये जो congress है ये बार बार होती रहती है. So it was organized by Cellular Operators Association of India. Option D. What is the full form of SWEEP, which is a flagship program of the Election Commission of India for voter education started in the year 2009? So remember, SWEEP stands for Systematic Voters Education and Electoral Participation. All right. Systematic Voters Education and Electoral Participation is the full form. Option A is the correct answer. With which of the following organizations, Department of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare has signed an MOU for promoting millets as the part of celebration for the of the International Year of Millets 2023. I hope you all know this. Bahut common si information hai ye. So it is NAFED. Option B is the correct answer. With NAFED, the department has signed this MOU, right? Question number 23. Consider the following statements with respect to Swachhta Sarthi Fellowship and you have to identify the correct statements. So this Swachhta Sarthi Fellowship basically is to sensitize the young students, the citizens and the sanitization workers towards the waste management, right? And they have been sensitized बाय प्रोवाइडिंग देम विद द फेलोशिप. ठीक है, उनको फेलोशिप प्रोग्राम के थ्रू सेंसिटाइज किया जा रहा है, राइट, अंडर दिस स्वच्छता सारथी फेलोशिप प्रोग्राम. इट वॉज लॉन्च इन 2021 बाय द ऑफिस ऑफ प्रिंसिपल साइंटिफिक एडवाइजर टू द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. अजय कुमार सूद है अभी. एंड थ्री कैटेगरीज द फेलोशिप इज प्रोवाइडेड इन थ्री कैटेगरीज. नंबर वन इज फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 9 टू 12, 500 पर मंथ फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ वन ईयर. देन सेकेंड इज फॉर द कॉलेज स्टूडेंट्स, वेदर इट इज यूजी और अंडर ग्रेजुएट और पोस्ट ग्रेजुएट, 1,000 rupees पर मंथ फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ वन ईयर अगेन. एंड देन थर्ड कैटेगरी SHGs एंड सैनिटेशन वर्कर, SHGs एंड सैनिटेशन वर्कर, ₹2,000 पर मंथ फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ वन ईयर. ऑलराइट, सो करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट आइडेंटिफाई कर लेते हैं फिर जल्दी से. इट इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स, नो. इट वॉज लॉन्च इन 2020, नो. द फेलोशिप इज गिवन इन थ्री डिफरेंट कैटेगरीज, येस. ओनली थ्री विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट आइडेंटिफाई करना था हमें, ओके. 24 पे आ जाते हैं. कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स विद रिस्पेक्ट टू ISA इंटरनेशनल सोलर अलायंस एंड यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन. करेंटली इट हैज 110 मेंबर. रिसेंटली भूटान इसका 110वां मेंबर बना है. एज पर द वेबसाइट ऑफ ISA इट इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन गुरुग्राम इन हरियाणा एज यू ऑल नो. एंड इट वॉज एस्टैब्लिश इन द ईयर 2015, राइट. सो करेंटली इट हैज 109 मेंबर्स, नो. इट वॉज एस्टैब्लिश इन 2015 विद इट्स हेडक्वार्टर्स at Paris, no, Gurugram. And ISA assembly is the apex decision making body of ISA, which meets 2 times in a year. No, it meets annually, yani once in a year, right. So none is okay, all are incorrect will be the correct answer, option E. Recently QR code based rapid OPD registration service has been launched under Ayushman Bharat digital mission. In which year the mission was launched? Very easy question, I think. Very, very easy question. 15 अगस्त 2020 को प्रधानमंत्री ने लाल किले के प्राचीर से इस स्कीम के बारे में अनाउंस किया था, राइट. तो आई होप लॉन्च ईयर तो इसका याद रहना चाहिए. द स्कीम इज ऑल अबाउट, द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ द स्कीम इज टू डिजिटलाइज द हेल्थ सेक्टर ऑफ द कंट्री. एंड आयुष्मान भारत डिजिटल हेल्थ कार्ड्स आर बींग गिवन. आयुष्मान भारत डिजिटल हेल्थ IDs. Health IDs are being provided to the citizens of the country, and जब यह पूरी तरीके से implement हो जाएगा तो सबके पास अपनी एक personal digital health ID होगी, right? It is being implemented by National Health Authority. National Health Authority is the implementing agency, and it was launched in 2020. Option D is the correct answer. Consider the following statements with respect to credit guarantee scheme for startups, and you have to identify the correct statement. This has been launched recently, and as the name suggests, credit guarantee scheme for startups, which means under this scheme, the credit guarantee is provided to the bank, to the banks for the loans which they have given to the startups. Or you can say credit guarantee is provided to the startups against the loan which they have taken from the banks. Okay? And under this scheme, there are various member institutions from which for which the credit guarantee will be given. All scheduled commercial banks will be there, right, and NBFCs will be there, and SEBI registered alternate investment funds. ये थोड़ा सा नया है तो ये याद रखना. SEBI registered alternative investment funds जितने भी होंगे, these are also the member institutions. All right, and it will be implemented by National Credit Guarantee Trust Company Limited. So this statement is correct. Transaction based cover will be 80% of the amount in default if the original loan sanction amount is up to ₹3 crore. Ye bhi sahi hai. Payment banks and small finance banks are among the member lending institution, no. These three categories of people, of banks, of institutions are the member institutions: scheduled commercial bank, NBFCs, and SEBI registered alternative investment funds. So correct nikalna hai to option A only 1 and 2 will be the correct answer. Which of the following ministries is organizing Pradhan Mantri National Apprenticeship Melas across 280 locations in 28 states and UTs? So wherever you see this word apprenticeship, without any doubt mark the answer as Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, which is headed by Mr. Dharmendra Pradhan, DP, and he is also the Minister of Education. The Eastern and Northeastern Cooperative Dairy Conclave 2022 organized by National Cooperative Dairy Federation of India was held in which city? Very simple, very direct question. It took place in Gangtok, which is the capital of Sikkim. I hope you all know this. Recently, Union Minister of State for Health and Family Welfare, Dr. Bharti Pawar, addresses the second meeting of high-level coalition on health and energy. Now, I will skip to the last line without reading the entire paragraph. The question is, which international organization conveys it? So, it was conveyed by WHO, which is World Health Organization. And of course, it is headquartered in Geneva. Conference on Industry 4.0, Challenges Ahead and Way Forward was recently held in Kevadia, Gujarat. It was aimed at sensitizing industrial sectors in the country to adopt digital manufacturing processes and to promote automation and innovation in the industry. It was organized by which ministry? Very simple question. Now, please don't get confused between the Ministry of Heavy Industries and the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. No, it was Ministry of Heavy Industries which organized it. Alright, option A is the correct answer, and this ministry is headed by Mr. Mahendranath Pandey is the minister. Alright. Next is National Workshop on Ease of Doing Business was recently held in New Delhi. It highlighted the key learnings of continuous process of the Ease of Doing Business exercise in India. It was organized by which of the following organization? Very easy. Ease of doing business की बात हमारे देश में एक ही organization करती है, and that is DPIIT. Option B, Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. However, कभी कभी नीति आयोग भी करता है, but this time mostly the answer is DPIIT. Option B. Consider the following statements with respect to Telemanas initiative, and you have to identify the correct statement. I hope you all remember this, that this initiative was announced in Union Budget 2022-2023. And now it has been officially launched. The objective is to provide the telemental health services, right? Basically to provide counseling to the people who are suffering from any mental health related issue. Okay. This will be provided through Center of Excellence. 23 Center of Excellence will be established across the country. NIMHANS will be the nodal implementing agency. The tech support. Right, technical support will be provided by IIT Bangalore and National Health System Resource Center. Alright, National Health System Resource Center. It will be implemented in two tiers. At first stage, the patient will talk to a basic counselor. Aur agar wahan se baat nahi banti hai, then he will be referred to a specialist in the district hospital. Right, so two-tier implementation will be there. NIMHANS is the nodal implementing agency. Yes, Telemanas includes a network of 25 telemental health center of excellence. 25 nahi hai, 23 hai. And the initiative will be implemented in two tiers. This is correct. 1 and 3 will be the correct answer. Option C. Okay. 33 pe aa jaate hain. Fourth edition of Heli India Summit 2022 was recently held with the theme Helicopters for Last Mile Connectivity in Srinagar, Jammu and Kashmir. During the summit, Helicopter Emergency Medical Service has been launched. Through this service, helicopters will be deployed to provide emergency medical services at which of the following aims? Now, this project, Helicopter Emergency Medical Service, they are also calling it as Project Sanjeevani. And it has been launched for AIMS Rishikesh. Option B is the correct answer, and Rishikesh is in Uttarakhand. Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade has hosted conference on B20 Indonesia Global Dialogue. B20 is nothing but the business arm of G20, you can say. It is the business dialogue forum of the member countries of G20. And that is why it is known as what? B20, business 20, you can say. Okay. So the question is, with which of the following industry the conference has been organized? Remember, it was organized in collaboration with Confederation of Indian Industry. Option B will be the correct answer. Ministry of Women and Child Development has organized National Conference on Skilling in Non-Traditional Livelihood for Girls, Betiya Bane Kushal. Betiya means girl child, Kushal means skilled. Alright. It was organized on the occasion on the International Day of the Girl Child under which scheme? Remember, it was organized under Beti Bachao, Beti Padhao. Beti Bachao, Beti पढ़ाओ, ऑलराइट। एंड द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ बेटियां बने कुशल इज यू नो टू एनकरेज द गर्ल चाइल्ड, टू एनकरेज द गर्ल चाइल्ड टू परस्यू देयर करियर्स इन द स्टेम फील्ड। एंड ऑफ कोर्स यू ऑल नो दिस, स्टेम स्टैंड्स फॉर साइंस टेक्नोलॉजी इंजीनियरिंग एंड मैथमेटिक्स। ओके, सो बेटी बचाओ बेटी पढ़ाओ इज द करेक्ट आंसर, ऑप्शन सी। द 10th मीटिंग ऑफ यूएई इंडिया हाई लेवल जॉइंट टास्क फोर्स ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट्स टुक प्लेस इन मुंबई। दिस वॉज द फर्स्ट मीटिंग ऑफ जेटीएफ सिंस द साइनिंग ऑफ इंडिया यूएई कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव इकोनॉमिक पार्टनरशिप एग्रीमेंट। इन विच ईयर द टास्क फोर्स वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड, टास्क फोर्स कब एस्टैब्लिश हुआ था? वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन, 2013 में एस्टैब्लिश हुआ था। एंड आई विल नॉट गो इन टू द डिटेल्स ऑफ दिस जॉइंट टास्क फोर्स मीटिंग बिकॉज वो बहुत लंबा है, तो उसके लिए आप सेशन देख सकते हो। 37. A lifestyle clinic has been inaugurated at Armed Forces Clinic, New Delhi, to provide advice on diet, exercise, and behavioral counseling for comprehensive, preventive, and curative care on lifestyle diseases. So you just have to name the clinic. So can you name the clinic? Very easy. It is Sanjeevani. अब संजीवनी बहुत सारे हो गए हैं, तो भाई please confuse मत होना। जैसे बहुत सारे साथी हैं, वैसे ही बहुत सारे संजीवनी हैं। तो please don't get confused. Okay? Question number 38. By which year India's geospatial economy is expected to cross 63,000 crore at a growth rate of 12.8% and to provide employment to more than 10 lakh people mainly through geospatial startup? And it was announced, so you can say it was called for by Union Minister of Science and Technology, Dr. Jitendra Singh. So it will be done by the year 2025 as expected. ठीक है, expectations है, अब let's see होता है कि नहीं होता है। With which country government of India has signed an MOU to improve the availability of muriate of potash, MOP, also known as potassium chloride, for the farming community in India and boost indigenous production of various grades of complex fertilizers? Can you identify this country? Yes, it is Germany. Option D is the correct answer. D, Germany is the correct answer. Now, can you tell me who is the Chancellor of Germany? Chancellor of Germany, batao. Write down in the comments who is the Chancellor of Germany. Which ministry or ministries has launched an online portal for handicraft artisans for allotment of stalls to handicraft artisans in various marketing events organized by ministry without any human interface? So, when we are talking about handicraft artisans, most probably the answer will be Ministry of Textiles, option C. And Ministry of Textiles is again is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal. He is also the Minister of Commerce and Industry and of course the leader in Rajya Sabha. Consider the following statements with respect to PM Divine and you have to identify the correct statement. This scheme was also announced in Budget 22-23 and now it has been officially launched. And as the name suggests, this scheme is for developing the northeastern region. Now, this development in the area of infrastructure, in the area of livelihood, in the area of employment opportunities, etc. So, basically, holistic development of the northeastern region. The total outlay is 6600 crores, 100% centrally funded, right? And it will be implemented till 2025-26. ठीक है ना? तो करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट आपको आइडेंटिफाई करना है. ओके, इट एम्स टू एड्रेस डेवलपमेंट गैप्स इन द नॉर्थ ईस्टर्न रीजन. करेक्ट, इट इज अ सेंट्रल सेक्टर स्कीम विद 100% सेंट्रल फंडिंग. ये भी सही है. इट विल बी अ सब्स्टिट्यूट फॉर एग्जिस्टिंग सेंट्रल एंड स्टेट स्कीम्स. नो, प्लीज डोंट गेट कंफ्यूज हियर. इट विल नॉट बी अ सब्स्टिट्यूट, इट विल ओनली फिल द गैप्स, राइट? व्हाटएवर सेंट्रल सेक्टर एंड सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम्स आर बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड इन द एनईआर, इट विल बी इंप्लीमेंटेड एज इट इज. सो व्हाट दिस स्कीम विल डू, इट विल फिल द गैप्स. ठीक है ना? So this is incorrect and it will be implemented for 4 years period from this to this. This is correct. 1, 2 and 4 will be the correct answer, option B. Identify the correct statement with respect to Grameen Udyami skill training program. Now very easy, the objective is to provide skill to the rural workers, right? Its phase 1 was launched this year 2022 in Bhopal. राइट, भोपाल में इसको सबसे पहले एज अ पायलट प्रोजेक्ट लॉन्च किया गया था एंड वेरी रिसेंटली द थर्ड फेज वॉज लॉन्च एक्सक्लूसिवली फॉर वुमेन इन Jharkhand, and that is why it was in news, right? It is an initiative of course, when we are talking about skill training, to kaun hogi ministry? Batao, Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, okay? So, Nodal Ministry is Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship, sahi baat hai. Phase 1 was launched in 2022, not 2021. And third phase was launched only for women's groups. This is correct. तो हमें करेक्ट निकालना है. 1 and 3 विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑप्शन सी. विच एक्सरसाइज वॉज कंडक्टेड बाय सर्टिन वॉट इंडियन कंप्यूटर इमरजेंसी रिस्पॉन्स टीम फॉर द पावर सेक्टर यूटिलिटीज. नाउ दिस एक्सरसाइज वॉज कंडक्टेड टू मेक देम अवेयर अबाउट द साइबर थ्रेट्स एंड हाउ दे कैन रिस्पॉन्ड टू द साइबर थ्रेट्स एंड इट वॉज नेम्ड एज वॉट पावर एक्स. ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. Consider the following statements with respect to digital banking units and you have to identify the correct statements. Alright, so 75 DBUs. Basically, what is the digital banking units? So, जैसे आपने देखा होगा कि ATM के अंदर बहुत सारे machines लगी होती है. These are that only. So, these digital banking units will help in providing the access to the financial services and the banking services to the remote and rural areas of the country. Okay? And 75 DBUs will be set up in 75 districts. All public sector banks, no, not all. 11 public sector banks, 12 private sector banks, and only one small finance bank will be the participating institution. Now, which is this one small finance bank? It is Jana Small Finance Bank. Okay, Jana Small Finance Bank. And the services will be available in two modes. This is correct. This is incorrect. This is correct. 1 and 3 will be the correct answer because we have to identify the correct statement. All right. Option C will be the correct answer. आगे चलते हैं question number 45 पे. Consider the following statements with respect to Bureau of Indian Standards and you have to identify the correct statement. Identify करना है BIS के बारे में. Remember, it is a statutory body established in 1986 under BIS Act of 1986. Which has now been repealed and replaced by BIS Act of 2016. Right? And the objective of this is to standardize, is to set the standards of the goods. हमारे देश में goods का क्या standard होगा उसको set करना is the basic objective of the scheme and it works under the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. Okay? So it is a statutory body established in 1986, headquartered in New Delhi. It functions under MOSPI? No. It functions under Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution. Alright, 1, 2 and 3 will be the correct answer, option A. The 2022 International Rural Women Day was observed with theme, Millets, Empowering Women and Providing Nutritional Security. It recognizes critical role and contribution of rural women, including indigenous women, on which date it is observed. It was observed. कौन सी date पे इसको observe किया गया था? Very easy question. It was observed on 15th of October. Option B is the correct answer. And for the very first time, this day was observed in the year 2008. Do remember this as well. Recently, Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman participated in joint World Bank IMF Development Committee meeting. Where was it held? So it took place in the headquarters, Washington DC. Option A is the correct answer. Option A, very easy question. Which country hosted the 6th edition of East Asia Summit Education Ministers Meeting? कौन सी कंट्री ने इसको होस्ट किया था? Again, very straightforward question. No need to go into the details. It was hosted by Vietnam. Capital is Hanoi. Option E is the correct answer. Which state has become the first in the country to start the MBBS course in Hindi? It is very interesting question. It can be asked in the examination because it is for the very first time that MBBS has been introduced in Hindi. Right? So, it was introduced in Madhya Pradesh. Option C is the correct answer. Shivraj Singh Chauhan is the Chief Minister. Coal India Limited, CIL, has signed 3 separate MOUs with 3 major PSUs for setting up 4 large scale coal to chemical projects in which coal will be used to extract the chemicals, okay, or you can say coal will be used to produce chemicals, right, through surface coal gasification route. That is not important. please don't go into the details of what is surface coal gasification route, not required at all. The projects will be set up in 5 states, which of the following is not one of the 5 states? So the 5 states are West Bengal, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu. And Tamil Nadu, Kerala is not among them. Option E will be the correct answer. Question number 51. In which of the following IIT supercomputer facility Param Kamrup and laboratory for the design and development of high power microwave components was inaugurated? And of course, it was inaugurated under National Supercomputing Mission. National Supercomputing Mission. And can you tell me where was Param Praveg installed? Write down in the comment section. Theek hai? So this Param Kamrup was installed in IIT Guwahati. Option C is the correct answer. The Department of Biotech is implementing Indo-US Vaccine Action Program jointly with the National Institute of Allergy and Infectious Diseases and National Institute of Health, USA. It was launched in which year? So it is a joint program of vaccine between India and USA. It is being implemented since the year 1987. Option B is the correct answer. Aage chalte. Which IIT recently hosted Inventive, which is the first ever all IITs R&D showcase to bring academia and industry under one roof to showcase India's global R&D strength? Now, can you tell me the name of this IIT? It is IIT Delhi. Very easy. Option C is the correct answer. Padha hua hai humne ye. Now, this is Global Hunger Index. Consider the following statements and identify the correct statement. It is released by UN. Sorry. FAO. Is that so? No. Concerned Worldwide and World Hunger Health. Concerned Worldwide and World Hunger Health or Health, whatever you call it. It measured the levels of hunger of 121 countries, correct? And ranking are based on scores varying from 0 to 100. 0 is the worst, 100 is the best. Calculated using 4 parameters. This is correct. Now, what are the 4 parameters? Undernourishment, child stunting, child wasting, and child mortality. These are the 4 indicators. Okay. And India has been ranked at 107th place with a score of 20.5. Ranking is 107, but score is not 20.5. Okay, so jab tak pura sentence dhyan se na padho, khush mat hua karo. Yahi tak dekh ke khush ho ke answer mat mark kar dena. Read the entire sentence. Okay. Score was 29.1 India ka with the serious level of hunger. And bottom pe it was Yemen. And the global average score of hunger, it was 18.2. Theek hai ji? So kya kya sahi hai, kya kya galat hai? This is incorrect. This is correct, this is incorrect. Correct nikalna hai. So correct is 2 and 3, only option B. Right, option B is the correct answer. Aage chal jate hai. Consider the following statements with respect to scheme of assistance to disabled person for purchase or fitting of aids or appliances, ADIP in short. And you have to identify the incorrect statement. So remember, under this scheme, government provides life supporting devices or equipments to the people who are disabled or challenged or physically challenged. It was launched in the year 1981. Right, 1981 mein isko launch kiya gaya tha. And remember, to have the benefit of this scheme, the monthly income should not exceed rupees 30,000 per month. 30,000 per month se zyada nahi hona chahiye. And from government of India side, for any equipment or device or aids or appliances, the maximum support that will be provided is 15,000. Theek hai? Uske upar NGO ya state government ya koi aur civil society organization hai, toh wo contribute karti hai. Right? So the scheme was launched in 1981, correct? For aids or appliances costing up to 15,000. Full assistance is provided by the government. Sahi baat hai. And 3% of the budget under the scheme may be used for providing information, education and communication regarding the scheme. Not 3%. 1% of the total budget of the scheme is used for these purposes. So this is incorrect. 1 and 2 will be the correct answer. Option B. Okay. Consider the following statements regarding Interpol and you have to identify the correct statement. Remember, इंटरपोल द 90th एडिशन ऑफ जनरल असेंबली मीटिंग टुक प्लेस इन न्यू दिल्ली एंड दैट इज व्हाई वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट इंटरपोल राइट इट वॉज एस्टैब्लिश्ड इन 1923 एज इंटरनेशनल क्रिमिनल पुलिस कमीशन ICPC बट इन द ईयर 1956 इट वॉज रीनेम्ड और यू कैन से revamped as Interpol. Right, it is headquartered in Lyon, which is in France, and currently it has 195 members. Ahmed Nasir is the current chairperson. Okay. So it is an intergovernmental organization facilitating worldwide police cooperation and crime control. Sahi hai. General Assembly is the supreme governing body. Correct. It is headquartered in London. No. It is headquartered in Lyon in France. Right, and 195 countries are its members. Ye bhi sahi hai. 1, 2 and 4 will be the correct answer. Option C. Correct nikalna hai? Yes. 57 pe aajao. Consider the following statements with respect to PM Kisan Sammelan. Kisan Samman Sammelan. And you have to identify the correct statement. Alright. So during the event, 600 Pradhan Mantri Kisan Samruddhi Kendras have been launched. This is absolutely correct. Bharat Urea Bags have been launched. Under Pradhan Mantri Bhartiya Jan Urvarak Pariyojana to help companies market fertilizers under the single brand name which is Bharat. Sahi baat hai. An international weekly e-magazine World Farmer has been launched to provide information on domestic and international fertilizer scenario. This magazine was launched but it was not named, the name was not World Farmer. The name was Indian Edge. The name was what? Indian Edge. Right? So this is incorrect. 1 and 2 will be the correct answer. Option A. Anubhav portal was launched by Department of Pension and Pensioners Welfare to provide a platform to retiring government employees to share their experiences while working in different ministries or departments of central government. When was this portal launched? So basically the retired persons provide their experiences when they were working in their respective departments. It was launched in the year 2015, option C. Okay. Question number 59. Mukhyamantri Amrutam scheme was launched in 2012 to protect poor citizens from the catastrophic costs of medical treatment and illness. It was integrated with Centre's Ayushman Bharat Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana. So basically, the scheme was launched by Gujarat's government. It was a health insurance scheme. In fact, it is a health insurance scheme. राइट बिल्कुल आयुष्मान भारत जो जन आरोग्य योजना है उसकी तरह थी ये स्कीम बट इन द ईयर 2019 इट वाज इंटीग्रेटेड इनटू आयुष्मान भारत जन आरोग्य योजना राइट द क्वेश्चन इज इट इज हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस स्कीम ऑफ विच स्टेट गवर्नमेंट सो इट इज गुजरात ऑप्शन बी विदाउट एनी डाउट रिसेंटली सिंगल इंटीग्रेटेड पेंशनर्स पोर्टल आई पेंशन वॉज लॉन्च टू इनेबल पेंशनर्स टू गेट ऑल द इन्फॉर्मेशन एंड सर्विसेज एट वन प्लेस विद सिंगल लॉग इन It has been developed by Ministry of Personnel, Public Grievances and Pensions in collaboration with which bank? Very, very important question. It was developed in collaboration with State Bank of India. Option B is the correct answer. World Spice Congress is the world's largest exclusive business platform for the spice sector. It has been organized recently by the Spices Board of India, which works under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Where will the 14th WSC 2023 take place? कहाँ पे होगा ये? तो World Spice Congress basically होगा क्या इसमें? So it will, it will bring together all the stakeholders of the sector and then to discuss and deliberate what are the problems and what are the prospects in the area of spices. Okay? And it will take place in Navi Mumbai in Maharashtra. With which organization India Post Payment Bank has announced its collaboration for bringing innovations in financial product and services to enhance the reach of financial solutions to large sections of society across India. Remember, very easy question. Out of the options, you can easily identify. It is RBI Innovation Hub, Reserve Bank Innovation Hub. It was established in the year, this year only 2022 in Bangalore. And of course, the objective is to provide access to the financial services across the country. Option B. Consider the following statements with respect to India-Africa Security Fellowship Program and you have to identify the correct statements. So this fellowship program was recently launched during the India Africa Defense Dialogue, which took place during the Def Expo. And of course, this took place in Gandhinagar, in Gujarat. ठीक है जी. तो मनोहर पारिकर इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ डिफेंस स्टडीज एंड एनालिसिस इज द नॉलेज पार्टनर. करेक्ट. द फेलोशिप इज फॉर द ड्यूरेशन ऑफ 1 to 3 months. करेक्ट. एंड रुपीज 1 lakh per month विल बी प्रोवाइडेड. इज दैट सो? डू यू रिमेंबर द अमाउंट? बताओ जल्दी. इट इज 50,000 पर मंथ, नॉट 1 lakh पर मंथ. सो 1 and 2 आर करेक्ट, विच मीन्स ऑप्शन ए विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. ओनली 1 and 2. 64. The 23rd AGM of Developing Countries Vaccine Manufacturers Network was held in Pune. It was organized by Serum Institute of India along with DCVMN. The question is, where is the secretariat of DCVMN? This DCVMN, it was established in the year 2000 to protect the people across the globe from infectious diseases by developing vaccines for those diseases, right? And it is headquartered in Neo in Switzerland. Now, please don't get confused Neo with Lyon. Lyon is the headquarter of Interpol, as we have discussed recently. It is located in France. And Neo is in Switzerland. Okay? 65. Consider the following statements with respect to Bal Vatika project and you have to identify the correct statement. Remember, this Bal Vatika project has been launched under the new education policy 2020. And it basically, it is intended to, work towards the holistic development of the child. Like for example, it's the child's well-being, the child's good education, right? To make the child effective communicator. So basically the holistic development of the child, okay? And it is an initiative, of course, of Ministry of Education under NEP. It has been introduced in all Kendra Vidyalayas. No. 49 KVs mein bhi isko launch kiya gaya hai. And it is for the students in the age group of 3+, 4+, and 5+. So this is also correct. 1 and 3 will be the correct answer. Option C. Okay, 6 lighthouse projects are being built at 6 locations across the country as part of Global Housing Technology Challenge India Initiative. Under Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban, which of the following is not among the 6 places where the LHPs are being constructed? So remember guys, this lighthouse project is nothing but we are using alternate technology to develop these houses, right? Or you can say the environmental friendly technologies to develop these houses. And that is why these are the special housing projects of the Government of India, right? And these are being built at Indore, Chennai, Ranchi, Agartala, Lucknow and Rajkot. And Rajkot wala to bhi recently inaugurate hua hai and that is why it was in news. Right? Pune nahi hai. Pune mein develop nahi ho raha hai, which means option C is the correct answer. Indian Urban Housing Conclave 2022 was recently organized by Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. During the conclave, Pradhan Mantri Awas Yojana Urban Awards were declared. Ye humne pehle bhi discuss kiya tha. So which state has been awarded the best performing state award? It was Uttar Pradesh among the last states, and among the northeastern and hilly states, it was Tripura. Northeastern and hilly states mein kaun tha? Tripura tha. Recently, National Crisis Management Committee met and reviewed the preparedness of central ministries or agencies and state or UT governments for the possible cyclonic storm over the Bay of Bengal. Who is the chairperson of NCMC? It can be asked because not Prime Minister, not Home Minister, not Defense Minister, Cabinet Secretary of India is the chairperson of this committee. Okay, so that is why this question is here. And who is the current Cabinet Secretary? Rajiv Gauba. Mr. Rajiv Gauba is the current Cabinet Secretary of India. Which ministry has organized a 2-day national training workshop on People's Plan Campaign 2022? To prepare district or block or gram panchayat development plans. So when we are talking about gram panchayat development plans, the ministry should be the Ministry of Panchayati Raj, headed by Mr. Giriraj Singh. And Giriraj Singh's Lok Sabha constituency is Begusarai, which is of course in Bihar. Recently, Prime Minister Modi announced 4th positive indigenization list during Def Expo 2022. So इस लिस्ट का मतलब होता है द आइटम फ्रॉम दिस लिस्ट विल बी प्रोक्योर फ्रॉम द डोमेस्टिक मैन्युफैक्चरर्स एंड दीज आइटम्स विल नॉट बी इम्पोर्टेड. ठीक है, तो हाउ मेनी आइटम्स आर देयर इन द फोर्थ लिस्ट? सो इट इज 101 ऑप्शन ई. Recently, Prime Minister Modi launched Mission Schools of Excellence. It is aimed at strengthening the education infrastructure by setting up of new classrooms, smart classrooms, computer labs. It is partially funded by the World Bank. It is the initiative of which state government? Can you tell me the answer? Yes, it is Gujarat again. Option C. ये दिल्ली का copy करना चाह रहे हैं, जो कि अच्छी चीज़ है कि चलो education को strengthen करने पे बात हो रही है. तो Gujarat is the correct answer. Consider the following statements about Competition Commission of India and you have to identify the incorrect statement. अब इसके आगे से बिल्कुल लास्ट क्लास वाला ही है, तो इसको हम जल्दी से खत्म करते हैं. It is the chief national competition regulator in India. Absolutely correct. It is a statutory body established under Competition Act 2002. ये भी सही बात है. It works under Ministry of Commerce and Industry. No. It works under Ministry of Corporate Affairs and is headquartered in New Delhi, not Mumbai. So, करेक्ट बताना है हमें, नहीं इनकरेक्ट बताना है. 3 and 4 विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर, ऑप्शन डी. ऑलराइट, वेयर वॉज द टारगेट, व्हेन वॉज द टारगेट ओलंपिक पोडियम स्कीम टॉप्स लॉन्च बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ यूथ अफेयर्स एंड स्पोर्ट हेडेड बाय अनुराग सिंह ठाकुर. टू आइडेंटिफाई ग्रूम एंड प्रिपेयर पोटेंशियल मेडल प्रोस्पेक्टिव एथलीट फॉर ओलंपिक एंड पैरालंपिक गेम्स. सो बेसिकली अंडर द स्कीम गवर्नमेंट प्रोवाइड सपोर्ट to the potential athletes of the country in the form of international level equipments, in the form of monthly stipend of rupees 50,000. So they will be trained for to fetch the medals, the international medals in the international sporting events, right? It was launched in 2014 and it was revamped in the year 2018. Option A is the correct answer. All right. Let's move ahead to question number 4. Blue flag certification is given to the cleanest beaches in the world to promote sustainability in the tourism sector and it is awarded by an organization which is known as Foundation for Environmental Education, which is a Denmark based organization, and recently 2 more beaches have been awarded with this certification in India. These are Minicoy Thundi and Kadmat Beach. So where is Kadmat Beach located? Both these beaches are located in Lakshadweep. Option C is the correct answer. As per the third advance estimates of horticulture crops for the year 21-22, what is the total estimated production of horticulture crops in 21-22? Very important question. Abhi advance estimate se NABARD ke phase 1 mein bhi question aaya tha. So that is why all the estimates are important. So it is 342.33 million tons in 28.02 million hectares area. Do remember this as well. Okay. Recently, Union Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare constituted 2 committees to reduce the delay in crop loss or damage estimation and ensure timely settlement of claims by farmers under weather-based crop insurance schemes, including Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana. Both committees will be headed by which of the following persons? Very, very important question. Dr. C.S. Murthy is the correct answer. Option D. Recently, eSaras portal, an e-commerce portal, has been launched for better and more effective marketing of Saras products. Remember, Saras is a brand. Saras is a brand for the products which are being produced by the self-help groups. This Saras initiative was launched by Ministry of Rural Development. This brand was launched by Ministry of Rural Development to give a name for branding, for marketing of the products which are being produced by SHGs, right? So it is the initiative of which ministry? It is the initiative of Ministry of Rural Development. And now the products will be marketed in a more efficient manner with the launch of this portal, which is known as what? eSaras. Which ministry has signed MOU with FIFA and All India Football Federation for launching Football for Schools initiative in India? फीफा चेयरपर्सन इज जियानी इन्फेंटिनो. बहुत टाइम से यही है एंड अभी वर्ल्ड कप भी शुरू होने वाला है कतार में. एंड दिस फुटबॉल फॉर स्कूल इनिशिएटिव बेसिकली इट इज इन द लाइन of NAP 2020 which talks about sports integrated learning. ठीक है, ये एक वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट है एनईपी का, स्पोर्ट्स इंटीग्रेटेड लर्निंग, उसके अंडर ये एमओयू साइन हुआ है. एंड ऑफ कोर्स मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एजुकेशन ऑप्शन सी 79 पे आ जाते हैं. करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट अबाउट नेगोशिएबल वेयर हाउस रिसीट्स. सो दीज नेगोशिएबल वेयर हाउस रिसीट्स आर नथिंग बट लेट्स से देयर इज अ फार्मर ए एंड ही हैज सर्टेन प्रोड्यूस इन हिज हैंड्स बट ही इज नॉट एबल टू सेल इट. सो व्हाट विल ही डू? He will go to a warehouse or a storage godown nearby his house. ठीक है, he will deposit his produce to this godown X. ठीक है, and in the return of his produce, he will get a receipt, which is known as negotiable warehouse receipt. Now, this receipt can be used, can be traded, can be sold, and can be used as a जो loan can be used as a collateral. Yeah. Can be used as a collateral for taking loan from the banks, right? I hope this is clear. It was launched in 2011 under Warehouse Development and Regulation Act of 2007. सही बात है. They are regulated by Warehousing Development and Regulating Authority (WDRA). ये भी सही है. They are issued by WDRA approved warehouses to depositors against commodities deposited in the warehouses. Correct. They can be traded, sold, and swapped. Correct. And they cannot be used as collateral for taking loans from banks. No, they can be used as collateral. So this is incorrect. So the correct statement, guys, is option D, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Moving ahead, which organization has successfully developed two dwarf varieties of Kala Namak rice, which is also known as Buddha rice, named as Pusa Narendra Kala Namak 1638 and Pusa Narendra Kala Namak 1652. It is Indian Agricultural Research Institute IARI. Option E is the correct answer. 7th edition of India Water Week 2022 is organized by Ministry of Water Resources. It is not ministry, it is department. Ye abhi tak correction nahi ho paya. I apologize for this. With theme Water Security for Sustainable Development and Equity, which are the partner countries? The partner countries are Denmark, Singapore and Finland. Option C, 1, 2, and 3 will be the correct answer. India Chem 2022 will be organized by Department of Chemicals and Fertilizers in association with FICCI. Its theme is Vision 2030, Chemicals and Petrochemicals will India, where it will take place. So it will take place in New Delhi, the capital of the country. Option D is the correct answer. Which country hosted the first Global Digital Health Summit Expo and Innovation Awards organized in partnership with global bodies working in digital health and co-hosted by the Internet Governance Forum United Nations? So it is our Pyara Bharat. Option D, India, is the correct answer. According to World Energy Outlook 2022, electricity generation through coal will peak around 2030, rising from 240 gigawatt in 2021 to 275 gigawatt in 2030. Moreover, by 2030, over 60% of growth in power demand will be met by renewables, accounting for 35% of electricity mix. WEO is a flagship annual publication of which organization? Right, it is International Energy Agency, which is headquartered in Paris. Option D is the correct answer. Which country has recently hosted the second the special meeting of United Nations Security Council's Counter Terrorism Committee? Once again, it is India. Option C is the correct answer. Next question pe aa jaate hain. Nationally determined contribution synthesized report is an annual summary of climate commitments made by countries under the Paris Agreement 2015 and their impact on global greenhouse gas emissions. It is released by which of the following organizations? Very easy question. It is released by United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change. Option A is the correct answer. And COP27, Conference of Party 27, will take place in Sharm el-Sheikh city. Sharm el-Sheikh city of Egypt. Okay, and COP26 took place in Glasgow. Which central public sector enterprise became the first to achieve the major milestone of procurement value of rupees 10,000 crore through Government E-Marketplace? It was Steel Authority of India Limited. एंड स्टील अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया लिमिटेड, सोमा मंडल इज द एमडी एंड सीईओ, एंड शी वॉज द फर्स्ट वुमेन टू बिकम द सीईओ एंड एमडी ऑफ दिस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 89 एंड द लास्ट क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस सेशन, आफ्टर हरियाणा एंड तेलंगाना विच बिकेम द थर्ड बिग स्टेट टू बी डिक्लेयर्ड 100% हर घर जल स्टेट अंडर जल जीवन मिशन. सो गाइज, इट इज गुजरात. ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑलराइट, एंड ऑफ कोर्स जल जीवन मिशन इज बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति हेडेड बाय गजेंद्र सिंह शेखावत. ऑलराइट, सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर दिस मंथली रिवीजन फॉर द मंथ ऑफ अक्टूबर 2022. आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर क्लियर एंड आई होप यू गाइस हैव स्कोर्ड वेल. जो भी क्वेश्चंस मैंने पूछे थे उसके प्लीज आंसर दे देना. ये मत सोचना कि अरे हमें तो आते हैं, ठीक है ना. डोंट ट्राई टू बी ओवर कॉन्फिडेंट. ओके, ऑलराइट, सो फिर मिलते हैं अगले सेशन में. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.